Hello, I'm Bill Rao from MS Rao in New Orleans, and what we have here are arguably the greatest pair of Pietà d'Oro tables in the entire world. What is Pietà d'Oro? Pietà d'Oro means hard stone in Italian, and it refers to all decorative stone-based objects that were done in Italy, whether it was mosaic or micro-mosaic, and of course, inlaid marble. And the greatest place in the world that one could ever acquire a piece of Pietà d'Oro from was from the Grand Duca workshops. The Grand Duca workshops were started by one of the most important people in the annals of art history, the Grand Duke Ferdinando I de' Medici in Florence in 1588. His patrons were the popes, were the kings and queens, were the most important nobility of Europe. But most of the pieces he made were small. Many of the pieces were 4 by 6 inches or 8 by 11 inches or 8 by 12 inches. Tabletops were exceptionally rare. There are very few large tabletops made and even fewer pairs. When one looks at the tables, this table has birds all the way around it with flowers in the center. Inlaid right here is Pietà Piscina, which is the Italian marble, also known as rune marble, because when one looks at it closely, it looks like ancient runes. This was only found in the alluvial riverbeds of the river in Florence. This tabletop over here is also extraordinary. Birds are the center of this one, with also birds and flowers all around, with also Pietà Piscina, but also different marbles that were unique to the Italian region of Florence. To understand the quality of these tops, it's really important to compare it to all what's known out there. There's a similar single top in part of the National Trust in England, and the Queen in Buckingham Palace has a smaller top. Pietà d'Oro was always highly valued. It's interesting to note that for a while, the single highest price of furniture ever to be sold in auction was a Pietà d'Oro cabinet known as the Badminton Cabinet. It had been owned by the Earl of Badminton in England, which of course where the game of badminton was popularized. This cabinet held the distinction of being for a while the first and second most expensive piece of furniture ever to sell on auction, as it sold in 1990 for roughly $16 million, and it sold about 16 years later for around $30 million. So for a period of time, it held the record of the first and second most expensive furniture ever to be sold in auction. These tabletops would be extraordinary all by themselves, but they're not. They have an equally extraordinary pair of bases that come with them. These bases were by the phenomenal Andrea Bustolone. Bustolone was known as the Michelangelo of wood. He was considered the greatest Baroque carver in all of Europe. People flocked to Venice to be able to buy his creations. When one looks at these tables, you can see how exceptional they are, from the cupids to the figures to the sirens in the centers. Look at the faces that create the feet of the tables. And the table bases are not quite the same. They are slightly different. Each one was carved to make it themselves a work of art. Other table bases by Bustolone are in the National Museum of Scotland, and one is in the Victoria and Albert Museum. There's a museum in Venice that has a whole room dedicated just to his carvings. Pairs of his bases, any carving of his, is an extraordinary rarity. So these tables have the most extraordinary tops on them, and they have the most extraordinary bases. What could make them better? A phenomenal provenance. So the tops were made originally around 1625 or 1650, and when they were sold originally, they were likely sold with just marble columns to hold them up. But in 1714, a gentleman by the name of Lord Lee of Stoneleigh Abbey wanted to add a small little wing to his house. Please see this picture of this little small wing. And he wanted to create the greatest Baroque home in all of England. So in 1714, he ordered these bases to match these tops to create the greatest pair of Pietà d'Oro tables in the world for his small little wing. They stayed in his family till 1962, when they were sold at Christie's. The gentleman who bought them from Christie's was the Disney family, from Orlando or Los Angeles, but from Florence. And the Disneys brought these back home to Florence, brought the tops back home, and they stayed in their home from 1962 until we just acquired them. So what these are the most extraordinary tables. They have the greatest pair of tops, the greatest bases, an extraordinary provenance, and are completely fresh to the market.